Hi everyone, my name is Kamini and I am a storyteller. I'm here at National Gallery Singapore and I'm part of Gallery Children's Biennale 2021, Why Art Matters. I'm going to be sharing a story with you today, and my story is all about the importance of trees and why we must respect nature. My story is inspired by one of 9 different artworks that you can find right here at Gallery Children's Biennale. Now, the artwork that I have selected is called Superstar by Jeremy Sharma and his 2 sons. Superstar is a make-believe world that comes alive through many different colorful stickers. And there's a very special bone in it too. Let's see if you can spot the bone. Are you ready to listen to my story? Let's go. Once upon a time, there lived a woodcutter. Every day, the woodcutter would go into the forest to gather some wood. He would look on the forest ground and he would look for fallen logs, old branches, twigs, and sticks. Sometimes he would use his axe to cut the pieces of wood into smaller pieces because the logs were very big and heavy for him to carry. Sometimes the woodcutter would go deep into the forest and he would come upon a dead tree, perhaps struck by lightning or some rotting branches. And then he would use his axe and he would chop and chop and chop the wood into smaller pieces. The woodcutter never used his axe to cut down a living tree. After he had cut all the pieces of wood, he would carry them into a bundle and he would go to the market and sell them as firewood. With the money that he got, he would buy food. He would buy food for his family to eat. Now the woodcutter, he had a son, a little boy. Now this little boy, he loved to play in the garden, he loved to eat delicious food, and he loved to sleep in his warm, cozy bed. This little boy, the woodcutter's son, did not like to go into the forest and follow his father to work. He thought it was boring and too much hard work. The little boy did not want to walk and walk and walk. He did not want to go looking and collecting firewood, pieces of logs, pieces of branches, pieces of twigs and sticks. He did not want to lift all the heavy firewood and take it to the market. All he wanted to do was eat good food, play in the garden, and sleep in his warm, cozy bed. One day, the woodcutter, he fell sick and he couldn't go into the forest to collect wood. And so without wood to sell as firewood in the market, he couldn't buy food for his family. So the woodcutter called the little boy, his son, to him and gave him his axe. The woodcutter asked the little boy to go into the forest and find some wood. Oh, the little boy, he refused to go. He complained, he grumbled, he mumbled. But finally, he picked up his father's axe and the little boy went into the forest. The little boy was now inside the forest. He looked all around him and he was surrounded by different types of trees. There were trees as tall as the sky, trees as green as the grass, and trees as wide and round as a barrel. There were so many trees. The boy looked up, looked down, looked all around him. And then he remembered his father's words, to only look down on the ground and to only collect the fallen branches, twigs, and sticks, and to never cut down a living tree. But that would be so much hard work. He would have to walk and walk and walk. He would have to search and look for fallen logs and branches and twigs and sticks, and he would have to collect them and carry them. It would be so much easier if he could chop down one tree. If he could cut down just one tree, he would get so much wood to sell in the market. So the little boy, he held his axe in his hands. He looked at the nearest tree. He lifted up his axe and stop! He heard a voice. The tree spoke to him. It was a jambu tree. Please don't cut me down. I am a jambu tree. I have sweet, pink, delicious fruit that you can eat and all the animals can eat. Please don't cut me down. The jambu tree was right. The jambu tree had lots and lots of sweet fruit for everyone to eat. The jambu tree was a useful tree indeed. And so the little boy decided not to cut down the jambu tree. He picked up the axe and he walked and walked and walked. He lifted up his axe and he looked at another tree and stop! That tree spoke to him too. It was a coconut tree. Please don't cut me down. I am a coconut tree. I have many, many leaves that you can use to weave into baskets and all sorts of things. I can even be used to make thatched roofs. Please don't cut me down. The coconut tree was right. The coconut tree had leaves that could be woven into many different useful things. And so the boy decided not to cut down the coconut tree. He picked up his axe and he walked and walked and walked deeper into the forest. And he saw a tree. He lifted his hands and stop! Please don't cut me down. I am the banyan tree. I provide shade and shelter. I protect people and animals. Please don't cut me down. The banyan tree was right. It was indeed big and cool and shady. The banyan tree was a very useful tree. And so the boy decided not to cut down the banyan tree. The boy, he walked and walked and walked, carrying his father's axe deeper and deeper into that forest. The boy looked around at all sorts of different types of trees. He saw trees that had fruits, trees for birds to make nests in, trees where animals could lay down on the branches, trees that gave shade. He couldn't cut down any tree. And then the boy remembered his father's words, never to cut a living tree and to only collect wood that he found on the forest ground. And so the boy, he knelt down, he placed his axe on the ground and he began to collect the fallen twigs and branches and sticks. All of a sudden, the boy heard a sound. The sound came from up above. He looked up and he saw a flock of white birds. They were flapping their wings and they were crying out loudly. The boy looked around him to see what was happening. And there he saw a strange figure standing right in front of him. Boys and girls, who do you think that stranger could be? The stranger had something in his hands. He gave the boy what looked like a stick. And the stranger began to speak to the little boy. I have been watching you, and I have noticed that you did not cut down any living tree. I am going to gift you with this present. It is a magic wand. Take this magic wand and use it to help yourself and all the people around you. But remember, never use the magic wand to ask for anything that is impossible. And whoosh! The stranger disappeared, just like that. And the boy held the magic wand in his hands. Boys and girls, what should the boy wish for? It had been a very long day and he had been walking and walking and walking. And the boy was hungry. And so the little boy decided he would test the magic wand and ask for something to eat. Magic wand, please send me something to eat. And all of a sudden, a white bird flew down, carrying some bananas in its beak. And the bird offered the fruit to the little boy. The little boy ate the bananas and he was no longer hungry. So the magic wand worked. He took that wand and he ran back home to show his father and tell his father all about the stranger that he had met deep inside the forest. The very next morning, the little boy, he woke up early. He picked up the magic wand and he began to think about what he should wish for. He remembered what the stranger had said. Use the wand to help yourself and to help everyone around you, but never use the wand to ask for something impossible. So the little boy thought hard. Magic wand, can I have some pumpkin seeds? All of a sudden, he saw something from the corner of his eye. It was a crocodile. The crocodile crawled towards him with a big happy smile and gave him some pumpkin seeds. The little boy took the pumpkin seeds, but now he had to plant them in his garden. He used the wand and he asked for another wish. Magic wand, help me plant the pumpkin seeds. And from this eye, he saw frogs hopping and hopping and hopping towards him. They took all the pumpkin seeds and they hopped and hopped and hopped into the garden and they began to plant all the seeds. The planting was complete. The little boy asked for one more wish. Magic wand, can you water my pumpkin seeds? Immediately, the clouds gathered and the sky turned dark and it began to rain and the field, the garden was watered. Right before his eyes, the little boy saw the pumpkin seedlings begin to grow. The magic wand had helped him and the people who lived in that village. The little boy took the wand and explained everything to his father. His father listened to the story about the stranger and reminded the little boy to only use the magic wand to ask for wishes that would help him and the people around him. His father, the woodcutter, reminded the little boy not to ask for anything impossible. Well, time passed and the little boy became very wealthy because he could sell all his vegetables in the market, and with the money, he bought a big house, nice fine clothes, and lots of delicious food to eat. Now, even more time passed and the little boy, who had become very wealthy now, became very, very lazy. The magic wand did all the work for him. On some days, the little boy would just sleep and lay in his warm, cozy bed. He wouldn't even get out of bed. He would use his magic wand and ask for wish after wish after wish. One day, the sun was shining brightly in the sky. It was such a hot, hot day. It was so hot and so bright that the entire sky was red in color. The little boy, he felt hot, sweaty and sticky, and the little boy was angry and unhappy with the mighty sun. He was so angry with the sun for being so bright and hot and shiny that he picked up his magic wand and made a wish. Magic wand, I wish to block the sun. Oh no, boys and girls, the little boy had forgotten the words of the stranger in the forest. Immediately, the universe was in chaos. All the planets, they lined up trying to block the sun. The volcanoes erupted and the oceans were boiling hot. All the animals and creatures, they were terrified. Now, boys and girls, the mighty sun cannot be covered or blocked by anything, not even by an impossible wish. The mighty sun became angry with the little boy, and the mighty sun shone down hard on the little boy, so hard that the little boy disappeared, and the magic wand disappeared too, and the entire universe returned to being in balance once again. Boys and girls, if you look around the world that we live in, everything is about balance. We should always remember not to take more than we need. And we must always remember to respect nature, especially the trees that give us so much. I hope you enjoyed listening to my story, The Tree's Lesson, which was an adaptation of an Eastern European folktale. Now, in my story, there was a stranger who gave the little boy a magic wand. Do remember to explore the artwork Superstar and look for the stranger and the magic wand. Find out more about Gallery Children's Biennale 2021, Why Art Matters, by going to this website, childrensbiennale.com. Thank you so much for listening to my story, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.